Hello friends, welcome to the first episode of the series on Taals and Thekas, or rhythms as we know them in English. Normally when you listen to music or when you listen to a song, you always focus more on the melody, on the music and on the words. But I have always been extremely fascinated, right since my childhood, with the thekas, the rhythms that accompanies all music. And really speaking, there is no music without rhythm, because rhythm is what brings life to the music. It makes the music moves, and it also defines the mood of the music, because a lot of music directors, in fact all music directors, use the tempo or the lay of the rhythm to depict the mood of the song. So a slow rhythm typically would be used for sad songs or very serious songs and so on, and faster rhythms would be used for romantic songs and so on. And in fact, if you're aware, till the 90s, All India Radio used to play music without any rhythms during the period of mourning when some great national leader or somebody passed away. So so that's the importance of rhythm in music. So what I would like to do in this series on Taals and Thekas is to take different taals, different thekas, and talk about each of them a little bit with examples. Now our Indian classical music is fairly unique in that sense that we have a number of different taals and different thekas and different kinds of rhythms. So we have rhythms which are 6 beats in the cycle. We have rhythms which are 7 beats, 8 beats, 10 beats, 12, 14, 15, 16, and so on. And I think our music is quite unique in that way. So I want to take each one of these and demonstrate to you what are the different kinds of variations that good accompanists and good rhythm artists bring into the taals and thekas to really embellish the music. So let's start with the simplest and probably the most commonly used theka in bhajans. So basically in semi-classical music, in bhajans and and thumris and so on and so forth, and also in old Hindi film songs. So let's start with Keherwa, which is basically an 8 beat rhythm, and it goes dhage na tinak din, dhage na tinak din. So basically dhage na tinak din, dhage na tinak din, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, and so on. So it's a 8 bit cycle. So let's just listen to what Keherwa actually sounds like on the dholak. If you listen to it on the tabla, it sounds very similar. So we'll play this piece on the dholak. Now Keherwa, as I said, is an 8 beat taal or an 8 beat theka, and it has two parts. The first part is called the bhari, the second part is called the khali. And we show the bhari and khali with a clap and a wave. Dhage nati nak din, dhage nati nak din. Dhage nati is called the bhari, and nak din is the khali. And it's basically, the heavy or the bass sounds in the bhari and the lighter sounds in khali. So we show it with a clap and a wave. And now when we listen to the Keherwa on dholak, listen very carefully to the variations, the beautiful variations. Listen to this variation. This is called the lucky. Beautiful variation. second part of this series, we will listen to a bhajan sung by Pandit Bhimsen Joshi in a theka called Bhajni Theka, which is a variation of Keherwa. So do tune in and listen.